Hello everyone! Welcome back to the What's What Studios. Today, we are going to talk about our need for metals in the energy market, especially the future of the energy market. And with increasing demand, how metals, copper in particular, play a role in pushing us toward electrification. That is, new power sources, new methods, and innovative technologies that help us work toward a brighter tomorrow. But before we get started, don't forget to like and subscribe below. In the industry of electricity, there are four distinct trends emerging: the energy revolution, the birth of smart devices and new infrastructure, the digital revolution, and international mobility. But they all have one thing in common: the need for more metal. To break down why metal is essential in today's energy market, I've brought in Christophe Allain, Global Portfolio Director of Nonferrous Metals at Nexans.
Thank you, Fred. Hi, guys. Fred, thanks for having me. Like you said, energy trends are changing and a massive demand for metal is already underway. This brings us to a variety of challenges, from copper scarcity, which can be partially compensated by recycling, and it is projected that worldwide demand for copper will reach around 40 million tons in 2030. Of that need, about 23 million will come from mines, and 10 million will be provided by scrap and recycling. There will be a copper scarcity, you can do the math, of more or less 7 million tons.
Wow, that's a lot. What is the solution?
Well, first, we have to produce more refined copper, which means developing more mines, more smelters, more refineries.
A lot more.
Well, right now, Nexans is well positioned across the world with four metallurgy plants in Canada, Peru, Chile, and obviously France. But as copper consumers, we need to secure the supply of refined copper from producers.
I see. But besides copper, are other metals used to supply energy across the grid? And is there a need for more of them as well?
These are some good questions, Fred, and the answer to both is yes. More aluminium and copper is needed for the power grids and transformers, and more nickel, lithium, and cobalt for EV batteries, and many, many others, in fact.
We've established that metal is very essential to meet our energy needs.
Absolutely, especially in the area of electrification. That is why recycling is becoming so pivotal. The more reusable material we have, the better. And don't forget about sobriety, Fred.
Like no wine?
No, like lowering our energy waste, cutting down on heating costs, disconnecting unused appliances, things like that.
Ah, energy sobriety. You should have said so. In fact, we have a previous What's What episode that talks a bit about cutting energy costs.
Oh, I know. I love that episode. Sometimes I wonder if I could be a What's What host.
Really? Oh no, you don't want to. It's much harder than it looks. Now, where were we?
Fred, I'm kidding you. And trust me, these days my plate is full in regards to work. But let's get into a little bit more detail of processes and institutions set in place to meet our metal needs. Founded in 1974, the IEA consists of 30 countries that together examine energy issues. Their goal is to advocate policies that are reliable, affordable, and sustainable. Right now, a big part of their mission is to promote the discovery of new supply sources, scale up recycling, and further establish its impact on metals.
I understand. Switching to renewable energy ups the need for metals, because uses of coal and gas or non-renewable energy could be substituted with processes such as solar and rechargeables. Hence, the copper and aluminum for cables and grid networks, or nickel, lithium, and cobalt for EV batteries.
You got it, Fred. But the IEA is not alone. The LME, or London Metal Exchange, is also working towards responsible sourcing.
Very interesting. Can you tell me about the history of the LME?
Well, sure. The LME was created in 1877, at the time where copper cables were first produced and installed. They are the main worldwide non-ferrous metals physical futures exchange, basically a financial market, and they establish pricing of metals between producers and consumers. Nowadays, they also set ambitious objectives, particularly related to responsible sourcing practices. This is done in close cooperation with the International Copper Association and the Copper Mark. But there are other concerns for one metal in particular, copper. Copper is an expensive metal with high saleability. Sometimes this makes it a precious take for those looking to score.
You mean like for thieves?
Yes. That's why we need to invent anti-theft solutions. By the way, Nexans is working on it with a program that provides permanent surveillance of copper cables, allowing the reduction of indirect costs due to cable theft.
Take that, robbers! Now we know about metals, energy transition, scarcity, various market stakeholders, and copper theft. But what is next for the future?
Well, as for my team, our main coming challenge is to set up assurance frameworks to demonstrate that not only Nexans is securing supply chains of metal, but as well metal which is responsibly sourced, produced, and offering the lowest carbon emissions throughout third-party audited documentation.
That's the spirit. Way to keep it official.
Speaking of spirit, I got a little something for you, Fred. A little gift from our loyal friends at the Lens Football Club.
No way, for me?
Yes way, check this out. After all, Nexans is an official sponsor of the team.
Wow, thank you, Christophe. But I should be helping you, no? Seems like you have a tough road ahead.
That we do, but it's nothing we can't handle, Fred. Besides, what's what needs you here at the studio? Together, we will keep fighting towards safe and innovative ways of supplying metal to meet our energy needs.
Christophe, thank you again for being here.
Fred, my pleasure. Thank you for taking me here. And friends, so long.
So, why don't kick off a quick summary of all we've learned today? The shift to renewable energy will require more nickel, cobalt, lithium, aluminum, and mainly copper. This will lead to a scarcity of metal resources required for future infrastructures. Recycling and sobriety are great ways to lower the deficit. The IEA and LME are institutions set in place to achieve stability, transparency, and fairness within the metal markets. There you have it, everyone. Got any more questions about metal, recycling, energy sobriety, or copper's role in our future of electrification? Feel free to drop a comment below. This is Frédéric tuning out. Salut!